Good Tuesday afternoon, Jennings County. I'm Trinity Wall, and you are watching JCTV News. If you have perfect attendance this semester, you could win a pair of shoes. The Panther Pantry will be held tomorrow at 3:30 p.m. Wabash College will be here for a college visit tomorrow. There will be a regional college fair at Hanover College at Tuesday from 6:30 to 8 p.m. Many colleges and universities will be there, financial aid people too. Do you want to nominate someone for the JCHS Alumni Hall of Fame? Nominations are due by September 30th. The Seymour Oktoberfest will be the first weekend of October. Fall break will begin on Friday, October 4th, and will be the end of the first 9 weeks. We are expecting a dry and hot week. Here is the seventh-day weather forecast.
Hi, this is Yula.
And
I'm Paula.
With the 7-day weather forecast. Heute ist Dienstag und es wird 86 Grad und morgen wird es 88 Grad und das Minimum ist 61 Grad. Dann am Donnerstag wird es 89 Grad und das Minimum ist wieder 61 Grad.
วันศุกร์นะคะก็จะมีเมฆแล้วก็มีแดดส่วนวันเสาร์ก็จะมีเมฆมากค่ะ
Van a subir también las temperaturas el domingo con 86 de máxima y mínimas de 65 y el lunes igual, máximas 84 y mínimas de 66. Chao.
Bye.
Bye.
The boys football team took a tough loss, so here's your sports.
Good afternoon, sports fans. Big sports news of the day is that we plan to take our gear to the gym and bring you a live broadcast of the volleyball game. The football team lost Columbus East on Friday 62-7. The 812 Driving Academy defensive player of the game was Rhett Berkman, who had 7 tackles.
Hey, Panther Nation. We hope to see everybody over at Madison for the annual traveling trophy game for the Railroad Spike. We got 2 excited teams ready to roll for that rivalry game. There's a lot of exciting stuff happening at Madison for the game. They're selling t-shirts and trying to make it a big deal, and I believe it's also their homecoming. So we're looking to take the Panthers over and spoil their homecoming and bring that trophy back with us. Hope to see you over there.
The Panthers will stay on the road this week and will travel to Madison for the Battle of the Railroads Bike. In regional action, undefeated Columbus North beat Roncalli 14-0. Seymour lost to Floyd Central 50-29, and Madison beat Carroll County, Kentucky 58-14. The boys tennis team won the Woodman's Tennis Invitational on Saturday. In the first round, Jennings County defeated Warren Central 3-2. Winning was number one singles player Parker Bales and the doubles teams of Cole Skinner, Luke Napier, Asher Moore, and Brady Sins. In the third round, the boys defeated Roncalli 3-2. Winning was one singles Parker Bales and the doubles teams of Cole Skinner, Luke Napier, and Asher Moore, and Brady Sins. The boys' cross-country team placed 7th at Brown County on Saturday. Creighton Young took 5th with a time of 15:38. Cash Summers, Dawson Leak, and Brock Machino finished 30th, 31st, and 32nd. The girls' cross-country team placed 12th. Alana Watts led the Panthers with 24th place finish. In college football, Indiana approved their 3-0 for the season. The Hoosiers knocked off UCLA 42-13. Purdue got embarrassed by the Irish 66-7. And on the national level, the Indianapolis Colts lost to Green Bay 16-10. The Indiana Fever season will end on Thursday night and will enter the playoffs as the 6th seed. The Cincinnati Reds season will end on Sunday the 29th, and they will not be in the postseason again. Here's a look at this week's sporting events. There are no games scheduled for tonight. On Wednesday, the girls' volleyball team will be home to East Central. On Thursday, boys' soccer is home to Columbus East. Girls' soccer is at Columbus North, and the volleyball team is at Columbus North. That's the latest in sports. Now into our birthdays and lunch menus.
Here is Mia Sylvie with Miss Hill's quote of the day. Mrs. Hill's quote of the day is, "By being yourself, you put something wonderful in the world that was not there before." Here is Mr. Stewart's class with Today in History.
Hello, my name is Rosie, and you are watching This Day in History. On September 17th, 1976, NASA publicly unveils its first space shuttle, the Enterprise, during a ceremony in Palmdale, California. Development of the aircraft-like spaceship cost almost $10 billion and took nearly a decade to build, and that's a look at This Day in U.S. history.
Don't have cable? We can be found on YouTube. Search for Jennings County High School News Channel. Our news program is recorded on Tuesday and Fridays. It can be seen on cable TV at 8 a.m., 11 a.m., 2:56 p.m., 5:30 p.m., 7:30 p.m., and 9 p.m. Does your nonprofit group have something to announce? Then send us an email at tv@jcsc.org. This is all for us. We will be back for Tuesday's show. See ya.
Most of us would say that we're pretty healthy, right? But do we realize how quickly that all can change? I myself, along with countless others, do understand that feeling. I'm making this to ask for your donation to Riley Children's Hospital, an organization that has been a massive part of my life for the last 4 years.
Doctors at Riley Children's Hospital diagnosed me with Chiari malformation, a congenital brain condition, in 2019. Following this diagnosis, I had surgery to correct this malformation.
Luckily, I had great insurance that helped to reduce the original medical bill of $150,000. However, other people might not be this lucky. Medical bills can become financial burdens so quickly and easily on people and can haunt them for years. This is where you come in.
Riley Children's Hospital sees around 300,000 patients every year, and if you make even a one-time donation, you could be helping reduce a financial burden on a family. Or your money could go towards research that doctors are doing to further expand their knowledge and resources to help as many people as possible. Though your donation might seem small to you, it will not go unappreciated. If you would like to donate, go to give.rileykids.org, follow the steps, and provide the needed information to receive your donation. Thank you.